The winds of change are about the only thing steady in the newspaper business these days. And at the Dallas Morning News Monday, the wind came by email.
Pretty difficult. It's actually blowing my mind.
For employees like Don Burks and Jeff Mosier.
We were told that we would get the email by 9:15. I got mine at 9:13.
10 seconds after I heard that, I got an email saying that I was one of them, so I knew that that was the end.
For Mosier, the end of a 24-year stint writing about energy and the environment. For Burks, the end of 11 years as a TV critic. Arnetta Watley, 6 years as an executive assistant, got packed in boxes today, too.
We didn't have no idea that 43 people were going to be let go today. Mm-hmm. So it was really a shock to everybody.
The DMN publisher said the move was part of their focus to become a subscriber-first digital organization, rebalancing financial resources so they're positioned for success and can deliver quality journalism for many years to come. But this is just the latest in a series of DMN layoffs since 2014, and an agreement to sell its original building in downtown Dallas fell through late last year. It still sits vacant looking for a buyer. Another employee told me over the phone that in an absurd way, this is actually somewhat of a relief. Working for a company and an industry with multiple layoffs and reductions over the years, with the employees always wondering if they were going to be next. For the newsroom employees who lost their jobs today, there is also concern that local journalism will suffer as more and more journalists are shown the door. But as she left, Arnetta Watley told me this.
I am great, honey. God has me. And I'm just going to get with him tonight, and we're just going to figure out what we're going to do moving forward. So I'm good. I really, really am.
A newspaper hopes it is also moving forward as it leaves 43 more employees behind.